we're going to discuss different winding factors like pitch factor, distribution factor, and why we should maintain coil span to be 180 degrees electrical. What are the advantages and disadvantages of short pitch coil? We'll see all those details. Let's get to it. Okay, I'm taking a simple winding. Okay, with one turn, we have one turn. This is one conductor, this is another conductor. Okay, and the distance is pole pitch. Coil span is equal to pole pitch I'm maintaining. Okay, so according to simple KVL, what we know is VAC, that's a coil voltage, VAC is equal to VAB plus VDC. That's it. I can rewrite the same as VAB minus VCD. Both are same because VDC is equal to minus VCD. That's what I did here. Okay. So, what is the voltage induced here? Under North Pole, let's take some voltage E is induced here. Under South Pole, obviously, it will be opposite. So, plus here, minus here. Alright. So, this voltage, if I take it as VAB is equal to E at an angle 0 degrees, I'm taking this as reference. So, angle 0. What will be this voltage? So, VCD is exactly opposite to this, which means E at an angle 180 degrees. Okay. Because why it is 180 degrees? I maintain this coil span equal to pole pitch. Alright. So, pole pitch, we know pole pitch is equal to 180 degrees electrical angle. Alright. So, that's why BCD is E at an angle 180 degrees. So, now if I draw the phasor diagram for VAB, this is VAB, E magnitude and reference. VCD will be, yes, 180 degrees opposite in this way. So, if I want VAC now, what I need to do? VAB plus minus VCD. Okay, this is VCD, minus VCD will be in this way. Plus means you will get this one. So, what will the magnitude of this? Length of this will be, if this is having magnitude E and this is having magnitude E, this will be having magnitude 2E. Alright? So, this is one case. Remember this case. Let's go for a second case. Second case is, what if I reduce this coil span by an angle alpha? Previously, conductor was here, but I placed conductor here. That is what? Short pitch. What is short pitching? Previously, coil span is equal to 180 degrees. Then it is called as a full pitch coil. But now, I'm making this second coil, second conductor, sorry, which is alpha less than the earlier. So, which means VCD is 180 minus alpha. What is alpha? Alpha is short pitch angle. Again, electrical degrees. Okay. So, why I'm doing short pitching, we'll see that later. For the time being, let's observe what if I do short pitching, what will happen? That's what we're going to analyze. So again, let's do the same, VAC, this is, if you want VAC, I want VAB and VCD, this is VAB, and VCD is 180 minus alpha, so VCD is here. So again, I'm doing the same, VAB plus minus VCD, so this is VCD, minus VCD is here. If I add these two, a simple parallelogram law, you will get this to be 2E cos alpha by 2. A simple derivation, because this is having magnitude E, this is also having magnitude E. So the resultant is 2E cos alpha by 2. Now let's see what has happened by this short pitching. What did we gain? Did we gain something by this short pitching? Let's find short pitch factor. Okay, or pitch factor simply. Okay, KP. KP is equal to, what is the definition for a pitch factor? It is the ratio of EMF induced in a short pitch coil to the EMF induced in a full pitch coil. So, EMF in a short pitch coil by EMF in a full pitch coil. So, how much is the short pitch coil EMF? 2E cos alpha by 2. In the earlier case, we got 2e. So pitch factor is equal to cos alpha by 2. So this is for fundamental. We have not considered any harmonics into this. So what if I have harmonics? If harmonics also introduced into this, then this angle will change. For a fundamental waveform, it is multiplied by just 1 because it is fundamental. Fundamental means 1. If it is third order harmonic, it will be multiplied by 3 times. The angle will be 3 times more. If it is fifth order, it is 5 times more. So in general, if you want to write Kp for any order of harmonic, then I will simply write here n alpha by 2, where n is order of harmonic, alpha is short pitch angle, that is in electrical degrees. I hope now you understand what is this pitch factor. So the conclusion here is, by using short pitching, means if I don't maintain coil span exactly equal to pole pitch, if I reduce it, then what has happened? EMF is reduced by this much factor. Okay, that is the reason why in case of DC machines, we try to maintain this coil span is equal to pole pitch. If this short pitching is a disadvantage, then why we go for short pitching in case of AC winding, AC machines? The reason is, by this short pitching, we can reduce some of the harmonics. Okay, so this is all about short pitch winding. Now let's go for, yeah, another point is, I can get the same cos n alpha by 2 if I extend the winding like this. If I keep winding instead of here, if I keep it here, that is alpha more, I'll get the same values. So that is called as overpitching. I'll get the same advantage of harmonics and I'll get the same disadvantage of a reduction in voltage. But why I don't use this is because it needs more conductor compared to this. Because both offer short pitching and overpitching offer same advantage and same disadvantage. But we prefer this short pitching because it takes less conductor length. It will take more conductor material. It's simple. Next one is, distributed winding and distribution factor. What is the distribution factor? So I am considering a machine, AC machine stator, and we have slots here. Okay. So the conductor in this slot is having direction like this. EMF induced in the conductor is having direction this way. Okay. So here, this conductor will be having in this direction. Alright. So this angle is slot angle. Slot to slot, slot angle. That is called as gamma. Slot angle in electrical degrees or radians. In case of pitch factor also we have seen alpha, that is also electrical angle, here also electrical angle. In this conductor, in this slot, sorry, EMF is this way, in this slot, and next slot. So each and every slot is having EMF correspondingly. Alright. So with the angle gamma, because of the distribution of the winding throughout the surface. If complete winding is placed only in this slot, then only resultant will be in this direction. All the vectors will be in this direction. Now what we'll do is, let's add up all these phasors. I'm adding all these phasors. If you add all these phasors, what has formed? A polygon. This is called as EMF polygon. Alright. Now let's split this complete coils or complete conductors into three parts. Okay. I'm splitting into three parts. So these three parts having their own resultant. Alright. So if we now look at these resultants, it will be a three phase, which is 120 degrees displaced. Alright. Let's now analyze one phase. I'm now taking one phase. What is this angle? This is gamma, slot angle. If this gamma is zero, that what I said, all these will be in one line. Okay, so if gamma is zero, concentrated winding, what is the resultant EMF? We have four. If each one is having a magnitude, if I take it as capital E, this is having a magnitude of capital E, then total will be 4 into E. in this case, a resultant one. In general, if you consider more number of coils per phase, let's consider it as M, where M is number of coils per phase. Okay, then what will happen simply, instead of 4, we'll have M into E. Alright, but in this case, as the winding is distributed, we got a phasor addition. So this length is obviously less than the value of what we get here. That is what given by distribution factor. So what is the definition of distribution factor? It is a ratio of EMF induced in a distributed winding to the EMF induced in a concentrated winding. Let's now look at that derivation. So I'm taking a bisection of any two phasors out of these four. I'm taking a perpendicular bisection, and that meeting point I'm calling it as O. And A, B, C, from O I'm extending to A, B, C, D, E. Okay. We know this angle is how much? Slot angle, that is gamma. And this angle is gamma by 2. Alright. So let's find this E in terms of gamma. So E is equal to, I can say, AB. That's what E, we're now naming it as AB, which is equal to 2 times of AA. It is just twice. So our aim is to find now this value in terms of gamma. Okay. So take this triangle OAA. From here, you tell me what is AA. Yes, OA into sine gamma by 2. OA sine gamma by 2 is this E. Alright, I hope this is clear for you. But what I need is, I need total EMF induced per phase for a concentrated winding. So we'll simply multiply with the M for this E, we'll get that value. M into 2 OA sine gamma by 2. Next one is distributed winding EMF. So if this angle is gamma, all these angles also will be gamma. So total angle is M gamma. This is M gamma. If you take now bisection of this line, AE, we get a point P, perpendicular bisection. So this angle will be M gamma by 2. From this red line to here, M gamma by 2. Again, for phasor addition, what I need is AE. AE is equal to 2 times of AP. Let me now find AP from the triangle OAP. You will get OA into sine M gamma by 2. Yes, that's what given here. So into 2 will be AE. So from equation 1, that is the definition of distribution factor. From the definition, what I can write? Equation 1, that is KD, is equal to equation 4 by equation 3. Then you will get sine M gamma by 2 by M sine gamma by 2. This is what the distribution factor. This is only for fundamental frequency. What if I go for harmonics? That is KDN. Like in case of pitch factor, all electrical angles will be multiplied by N. In case of pitch factor, we multiplied alpha with N to get a generalized expression. In this case, we multiply gamma with N to get generalized expression. N gamma by 2 whole by M sine N gamma by 2. So this is what distribution factor and pitch factor. And here also, I forgot to say, even though we got a less EMF, why are we still going for distribution winding? Because, yes, we'll get an advantage of reduction in harmonics. Okay. So I hope you understand these two concepts. Please like the video and share the videos with your friends. And do subscribe to our channel for more such videos. Thank you.